Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I'm going to talk about the most practical application for reflection that I have personally seen. And this is an application that I have waited for myself since at least 2008. So I guess it's about 17 years or so that I've been waiting for this. So be sure to stay tuned for this episode. In this episode, I'm going to make use of my constexpr-capable Lisp-like embedded scripting language for C++ that I've been working on for the last few years now. This is intended to be very simple and lightweight and easy to use. And I'm going to show you how I have used C++ 26's reflection to make it even easier to use. Before I continue, I do want to remind you that I am available for code reviews and on-site training, and you should be sure to contact me for those services. We're going to start at the bottom and work our way up in this file, and hopefully everything will all make sense by the time we are done. Now, notice I have this namespace that I've declared. This is lefticus colon colon interface. And in here, I have declared four functions, q, u, myfloor, and print. Q simply prints q called. U prints u called. Doesn't actually do anything with these parameters. Myfloor does a cast to an integer from a double and returns the result. Print prints out the value of an integer that has been passed in. I am creating my evaluator engine here. Now I am calling this bind function. This bind function uses this funny little syntax, these two carrots here. This new syntax was added in C++ 26. Now, I'm probably going to get some of the terminology wrong here, but what it does is it gives me a meta object that represents the members of this interface, or represents the interface itself. So I am saying, give me an object that represents this namespace, whatever this thing is. In this case, I'm using namespace. It could be a class, it could be whatever. I am saying, give me something that represents this namespace, and I am passing in the evaluator object that I have created here. And then in my evaluator, I am just calling evaluate, and I'm giving it this script here. Now, this script should print first q called, and then second u called. And then it should print 3 plus 2 plus 13.9 is going to be 17.1. Call my floor on that. That should be 17. So I should get the value is 17 printed. Let's go ahead and enable execution. Just as I predicted, u called, and the value is 17. And I just realized while working on this episode that my scripting engine, constexpr, is 100% constexpr capable. So let's go ahead and move the work that we're currently doing at runtime, which is binding all of the members of this interface, to compile time. Anyhow, it's possible to instantiate an object of this thing at compile time. All right, a const eval make evaluator. Now, I am calling this bind function with the interface namespace. The interface namespace contains these functions. So I can very easily just add another function to my scripting interface and then use that function in my scripting interface like this. Now, I'm just calling these functions that take no parameters at all. Nullary functions? Null? Or anyhow. Let's go ahead and look at the magic of this thing. The bind function, it's first of all saying that it needs some sort of context. So it's saying unprivileged access. This is saying anything that is publicly visible here is what I want to reflect on. Notice the type itself, the thing that I'm going to loop over, is a class non-type template parameter. We're using this template for syntax, which was introduced in the previous episode, and doing a constexpr auto mem. So this is the member of the namespace. This is giving me each of the members of the namespace as whatever they happen to be. Now I'm saying bind the member of this namespace, and again, this is a template parameter, and pass in the engine. The engine is a runtime parameter. Now we can see over here that F was actually printed like we expected it to be. The bind member function is actually really, really simple. This is saying if constexpr, so we're doing a compile time check, is this a special member function? We want to make sure this is not like a constructor or a destructor or something like that. We don't want that here. This should work for classes as well, but for the sake of this demonstration, we're just doing members of the namespace. And you can put anything in here, anything that you're used to using this kind of binding-like interface with, like sol2, luabind, pybind11, chyscript, whatever. I'm prototyping it with constexpr, and you can play with this yourself when you look at the links at the bottom of this video. So we're using this splice thing. This is a special syntax added in reflection. This requires a constant expression, so the member itself is a constant expression. It is a class non-type template parameter. Now I am just using an ampersand here. I'm saying give me a pointer to this member with this splice syntax. So now it's giving me back the actual member. In this case, it is a function. And I am using the ampersand to give me a pointer to that function. And then I'm using this display string of, and this is again a part of the reflection API. There's a whole lot in the reflection API, and we're just touching on just tiny little pieces of it here. So I'm saying give me back the name of this thing, and the end result being that I can easily add things into this namespace, and whenever I change the namespace, it will automatically add the new things in that namespace to my scripting engine, which I find absolutely amazingly brilliant. This is so much simpler than any other thing that I've ever had to do when trying to write scripting bindings for other languages. We're always falling back to using something like Swig, or having to explicitly name all the things, or doing compiler hacks, or using libclang or something else. Now it's all built into the language. I can just say, go ahead and walk over the members of this class, this namespace, whatever, and automatically add the things to my scripting engine. And I just think this is brilliant. Hopefully you are as excited about this as I am, and hopefully this made sense, and you can just go ahead and play with this yourself on Compiler Explorer and see what you get out of it. So thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe, and I will catch you in the next episode.